Hey guys, AnaFan97203 here. Today, we're going to be, first of all, checking out what I've got so far in Grand Theft Auto, because I can. And then, after that, we'll probably rob a couple of convenience stores, and, I might give you guys some tips on how I like to do it. Of course, some of you guys might have even better ideas on how to do it. If you think you do, you can comment down below about that. So, first of all, I have this apartment. It is... what is it called? Let me see. Alright, so it is called Del Perro Heights. This is apartment 20. So, the apartment itself is just one of the high-end apartments, nothing too fancy there. The car is really the only thing to show off here. So, into garage. Actually, I have three properties as of current. I have this one. I have a medium house and a medium garage. Alright, so obviously, first thing you see here is my white van. Haven't customized it yet. Might leave it like that, just at a comedic value. We'll see. Here, I have a nice black and gray older style of car. It's a little nice looking. I like it. Here we have my four-seater crew car, which I recently got fixed up, so now it's actually ready to be used. Now it's got bulletproof tires, some armor, it's got the proper paint job and the crew emblem on there. It's got nice four seats in there, so I can take four people with me, which is always nice. And that's kind of been something I've been needing. Here I've got my failed attempt at making a Jurassic Park Jeep in this game, because I heard other people have done it. So I attempted to do the same, which is why the whole group is based around that Jurassic Park symbol, which you can't even see on the hood of that one. You can see it much better on the hood of this one than the other one. This is a free car I got. I don't remember what it's for, I don't remember how to get it, so don't ask. But it is a nice one. I got it all painted up. I think I upgraded a little, but I don't think anything performance-wise. Definitely not bulletproof tires. So this is like a two-seater crew car, but I can't use this one yet. Usually, if I want two-seater, I go with my Mustang, which is my main car, because this is the one I've put the most money into, both on how it looks and performance-wise. First car I put bulletproof tires on, first car I armored, and I had this great idea, got from a guy, Snuffy, a friend of mine, where if you put these kind of plates on the back window, it's much, much harder for them to shoot through the back window while you're driving away. So as long as you keep them behind you, you don't have too many problems. And of course, I love Mustangs, if you didn't know. My favorite type. So, you know, it's cool. It's a newer Mustang, but still cool. Here we have a Camaro, which I had painted up. Originally it was going to be the two-seater for the crew, but I didn't like how the stripe was looking for the crew, and then I got that one for free, and I'm like, I'm going to use that one. Might take that one out for a spin later. I would definitely use the Mustang later. Here I have a convertible because I wanted a convertible. So I stole a convertible. Then I painted it orange. Because if you haven't noticed, most of the vehicles I own, and you'll notice this even more later, are either crew colors like they are here, which I think this is the only building with crew color cars. Maybe one other. Or orange. Because I like the color orange. It's amazing. And I can get the paint for semi-cheap. So that's what's in this garage. Now, we're gonna cut away, and you'll see in my medium-sized house. Be right back. Now, I did realize that I forgot to mention, you guys might have seen a motorcycle while I was touring the 10-car garage. I do have a motorcycle. It's a dirt bike. Kinda wanted a street motorcycle. Didn't end up with that. But I did forget to mention that before. So, you know. Now you know. Alright, so now we've arrived here at my other apartment. I'm gonna leave this outside. Actually, I should have room for... well... I should have room for one more car in my garage. So, I'll put this in here temporarily, just so it's safe. My last garage has almost no cars. These two, the first one that I showed you and this one, are pretty much packed, because the last one I just recently got. This one seems a lot darker than my others. But yeah, so it does look like I had some room. That's good. Alright, so, ignoring the Mustang that I already showed you, I have this, which is the whole reason I have this car, is because of an anime called Initial D. I thought the car looked like the car from that, except with headlights, so I painted it like that. That is literally it. Yup. So, yeah. Alright, here we have a Charger, which I got. I think this is the first car I got. That one over there might be the second, maybe the third. And then the Mustang would have been the second or the third, whichever one that wasn't. But the Charger here was the first one. Yeah, you can tell. I may or may not like orange. These cars together don't look too good, but alone, they stand out on the streets and look good, so I like it. I got this one. I don't think this one has any upgrades. This one, I think, has one upgrade, and that thing has none. They all have insurance on them, though, so yeah, go ahead and throw a sticky bomb in my garage. You're gonna be losing a lot of money, good sir. There's a reason I have insurance on everything. There's also a reason I have no money, but that's another story. This thing was originally going to be the crew car, because I thought, you know, getting a big old truck, that'd be cool. I'm like, well, a truck can't fit enough, so we'll get an SUV. But then, I decided, you know, there's no reason for me to have that much space from people, because there's never all that many people who were with me. Well, now there have been a lot more people who have been joining me. So now, I do need that four-seater, but I decided to get the other one, because I wanted a car instead. So, you know, yay. Alright, so this is, of course, the medium apartment. There's nothing too interesting here. Definitely like the high-end apartment more. But hey, stuff's gone down here, so, you know. Alright, so now we will be heading to the final property of mine, which is just a six-car garage out in the middle of nowhere. Partially because I wanted another garage to store cars that I wouldn't do anything with in the future, which is probably where I'm gonna stick that one. Which, I mean, this one kind of serves that purpose too, though. And also a place where I can put some cars, because it's out in the middle of nowhere, which I've been to a few times, and then I'm just stuck there. Because I don't have the time to pull up my phone, call somebody, I just gotta run, I got the police on me, you know? So, be right back when we head there. So, I mentioned how I was gonna give you tips on, you know, robbing places. First tip is don't take a muscle car into the mountains. These things can't turn very well, they go really fast. Yeah, it doesn't end well. Oh, okay. I've fallen down cliffs many times in this thing. It's got armor enough that it can survive it, but at the same time, I'd prefer not to. Which is why, you'll see, I've got an off-roading truck SUV thing in the garage that we're about to get to. Should be almost there, I believe. Oh wait, yeah, here it is. Just up here. Also, try not to use muscle cars while it's raining. That's also gone really badly for me in the past. Oh, come on, you're not gonna let me break through that? Come on. Oh, jeez. Okay. Well, what are mechanics for, right? Oh, wow. Barely can even tell it's a Mustang. Oh, car expert would be really, really mad at me. Alright. Well, we're here. A couple of guys standing there for no apparent reason. Most of this isn't technically mine. It's just this garage here. So we'll go ahead and head on in. And we'll show you the one last car that I got. Which was in my spree of attempting to make a Jurassic Park Jeep. It's right here. Now, the reason I've kept this and not sold it is one and only one reason. And it's because this is my only off-roading vehicle. And it does have enough space, so off-roading-wise, this is not only the best I got, but one of the best, like, possible to get. So, yay! Does it have... No, it does not have the, symbol. I kinda wanna see what happens if I walk over here. Huh. I didn't know this stuff was here. I just recently got this one. I recently got this because I was almost out of garage space. Okay, I can't exit through there. That's odd. But okay. So, those are all of my garages. Weaponry. Can't get that out in here. So I'll just drive on out real quick. And then I'll get out, pull out my weapons, and show you what I got. And then we'll go ahead and attempt to rob a convenience store. Really? Y'all are gonna shout at me? Okay. Alright, so, got a rocket launcher. Grenade. Sticky bomb. Jerry can. Probably join Flying Aces here in a minute. I got the regular pistol, heavy pistol, and the flare gun, because the flare gun is so much fun. Admit it, you know it is. I have the micro SMG. I have the bullpup rifle, which has served me very well, and the sawed-off shotgun. Heavy pistol and bullpup are probably my two most used, rocket launcher being a close second just for when, as I like to call them, chrome domes, or really rich people with chrome supercars who have nothing to stop them. Or even richer people with extremely fast and overly upgraded chrome armored cars. Yay! Yeah, rocket launcher deals with them in a couple of shots. Which actually, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay. Which, actually, I do need to get more rocket launcher ammo soon. Why is there a tire in the ground? Whatever. Yeah, so, get back to you once I get there. Okay, so it looks like there's one real close by. As you can see by the map, I'm still right next to my garage. But there is one store that I love so much, because it is right next to a giant sewer opening. So you rob the store, run out to the right-hand side of the store, and then right there will be a giant sewer. You swim on in, and it curves too, so the cops will not find you. And even if they do, you can still swim in there and escape. Now, let me go ahead and show you on the map where it is. Map, it is... Right... The gas station's a good one to rob, too. There's some alleyways in there that are good to hide it. But not quite as good as this one. There it is. It should be right over here by the beach. Not too far from the, walkway and whatnot over here. Boardwalk. But yeah, right here, you see this? This is the sewer. Okay. I don't know why they have it drawn like that. But in-game, it kind of curves off to the side here, and then keeps going like that. So you just go right there in the corner. The police will not come in and find you, and they will not be able to see you from the outside. And you sit in there, put your money away in the bank on your phone, and wait for your stars to go away. And you can go ahead, run up here if you're like me and you have this apartment. You can run up here and rob this place without even having to walk that far from your house. But those mostly are circumstantial reasons as to why I like to rob those. Let's show you what happens when I rob this one. We'll see. This is why you want to have an armored, fast car. Possibly a supercar, possibly not, depending if you feel like being a jerk. You look like Wolverine. You look like you're going to be a problem. Okay, he's gone. You're going to give me the money. You cannot let people stay near you when you rob a place, because they will pull out guns and kill you sometimes. Not always. Sometimes, though. And when they do, that's a random person who's shooting you, either injuring you or killing you. Keep your gun pointed just in case they attempt to pull a gun out. If they don't, okay. He didn't. If he does, of course you just cap him. Okay. Now, we're gonna take a right. And this is why muscle car is not the best. I'm already losing them, as you can see here. Just here by the map. Which is good. You should be losing them already by the time you get out of the store. If you are not, you've messed something up horribly. If you've got a fast car, just drive away. It's very simple. Just avoid the cops and drive away. It's very easy to do out here. If you do not have a fast car, find an alleyway. Stay hidden. Do not let anyone see you. If you follow those steps, not really steps, but if you follow those tips, you will not have any troubles with robbing places like that. And, as we saw here, I got almost $2,000. Although it's not amazing, it's not all that bad. For how much effort I had to put in, that's not too bad. I got that done pretty quick. So, you can do a good number of those and get about $10,000 not too long. And it doesn't take too much, like, work. So that's a really good way, if you are a lower level person, to get money. Now again, fast car. If you have any sort of fast car, which if you don't, probably should try and get one sometime. Either by stealing it like I did, or by paying for it legitimately. Either way, if you have a fast car, outdrive the cops. You can go off-road, and they can't. Big thing there. And of course, you don't have to pay attention to any sort of traffic or anything. Of course, they have to pay attention to traffic. If you do not have a fast car, hide in an alleyway, or on top of a building is also a good place. Make sure that you cannot see the cops. If it's a building that, like, the roof is indented, and the roof actually has walls to it, perfect. You can hide up there, as long as the cops don't see you go up there. You know? Like, if your stars are flashing when you go up, and the cops don't spot you while you're up there, you are good to go. You'll be able to put your money away and just kind of take a nap up there. You're fine. If they do spot you, then, well, you're kind of screwed if you don't have a fast car, you're low level, and you get spotted. Yeah, you're screwed. Unless you have your own plan, then you might not be. And again, point your weapon at the clerk and slowly back out when you go to leave, so that if he does pull a shotgun or an AK-47 out on you, you can deal with the problem before it even becomes a problem. Because he will gun you down before you even get a chance to leave. They can shoot you through those windows. Once you exit the door, that does not mean you're safe. But they will always pull out the gun before you leave. They will not wait until you've left to pull out the gun. Last tip that I didn't do then, because there's nobody outside, is you ram, if you're not using a car that you want to keep, or you don't mind the car getting damaged, I should say, ram the car into the front of the store. Don't block the doorway, but ram it into the front of the store a couple of times. Anyone who's standing outside will go running away screaming. It happens. You don't have to worry about anyone coming into the store with a gun and dealing with you themselves, or getting shot at from the outside, which has happened a few times, and that can end you quickly, because you don't know where it's coming from, and you don't know what's going on. You just know you're taking a lot of damage really quick, and you can't leave and stop this. You know, you can't just leave, because the clerk may pull a gun and kill you too. So, follow those steps. Your robberies are going to go pretty smoothly. Now, will those be an instant guide to surviving? No. There have still been times where I've had to use the fact that I've got a rocket launcher and friends to get me out of these things alive. And your driving skill does affect things, you know? Like, mine's not the best, but I can kind of shoot out of the vehicle okay. Like, I've gotten a bit better at drive-bys. So now, or at least with the Mustang, I've tried to drive by with a supercar. That does not happen. But as you can see, causing all this havoc, it's gonna slow down the cops, and I could unload on these people. Not going to right now. I don't want to deal with cops. But if I wanted to, I could be shooting out these people's tires, causing more havoc. Kind of spinning my car around. Obviously, it's best to spin your car around if a cop bumps into you. But then I can kind of drive backwards, shoot out my front windshield, and then when I'm taking too much fire. Let me see if I can get this. Okay. There we go. Backwards driving, people. It's not as quick, but it can allow you to shoot out some cops real quick. You just flip it right around. Which is very easy to do in a muscle car. Because they flip around real easy. You bolt off. So, those are my tips and tricks on how to rob a convenience store. And, of course, at the beginning, my list of what I've got. So, if you have those exact same things and you follow those tips, good for you. If you don't follow those tips, good luck, and if you do, again, you still may have issues from time to time. You are committing a crime in high speed and gunfire. There's a lot of variables there, but that is, as far as I've found, the best ways to do it. So, I think that's all for now. Like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Wait, forgot, comment down below any ways that you guys have on how to rob convenience stores and whatnot. I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye.